see how magical this area is. I can't even use any other words, just magical. It looks like it's out of a storybook. It's crazy. Last night we camped here close by, and I had a dream, and I never remember my dreams. I guess I have dreams, but I never remember them. And I had this dream about a magical forest, and where you walk through and everything would, you know, the forest was helping you do everything as you were going. But and this is like one of the most beautiful areas I've even been to. Camera can appreciate some of this. I mean, people obviously camp here. You put your tent here. But it's not a campground. This is part of the forest. It's close to a road, so. Look at this. We just found this place. This is off next to this creek. In a bend in the road, you just go out here. I guess I say magical, it's just there's no signs of humans anywhere. There's no litter. I mean, yeah, there's a fire pit. Other than that, there's no trash. Sorry, it's early in the morning. I just woke up. I'm gonna get back over here. But I mean, it's just picturesque. It's just beautiful, beautiful. Look at this. A little walkway in the creek. I mean, this is why I love Oregon. Like, it's like this. Crazy. I mean, look at this, guys. It's just... definitely a magical area. People work long and hard to get their front yards to look like that, you know, or, and that's a postcard right there. Anyway, I was just amazed by how awesome it is back here. The only problem with it, for what my purposes were, staying next to this creek, is it's too loud to hear any noises in the woods. But it was late and we had to stop somewhere, put our tent out. So check this out, it's awesome. Tomorrow, hopefully, we'll get to a good spot where we can hear noise all night. But... And when you're right here next to the creek, you think you hear all kinds of sounds. Man, how awesome is this place? This is no campground, this is just right off the road. This is the kind of place I want to find, but I want to find it way off the road. Not right next to the road. I do want to start filming myself too. I am Dave, the Clackamas Sasquatch on YouTube right now. I do want to start filming myself and putting my face on here for a little while, but it's just, the subject is kind of, you know, it's Bigfoot, so I don't know about putting my face on here for a long time, but I know a lot about it, so if anybody wants to say I'm crazy, I have proof, you know. It's not like we don't know they're real. Any argument they have, I'll argue. There's no evidence. Well, there's so much evidence. Footprints and hair and all kinds of stuff. We have evidence that nobody, and there's 7,000 sightings that I have on a map. And that's 7,000 sightings of Bigfoot. I mean, that should be proof right there. Why is that not looked at? There's not 7,000 sightings of vampires. Or there's not 7,000 sightings of werewolves. No, it's 7,000 sightings of Bigfoot. It's not like it's not being seen. What are the other arguments? There's no place for him to hide. If anybody says there's no place for him to hide, they haven't been out in the wilderness. That's all there is places for them to hide. Especially if they're in low numbers. You know, a couple hundred per state even. If there's 100 Bigfoot in Oregon, I mean, and they live in the forest, chances are nobody barely ever sees them, and that's what it is, you know? Nobody, people see them, but it's not all the time. Anyway, I get a little passionate about it, too. So, yeah, I'm putting my face on here. I don't care. And I do want you guys to get to know me better, because when you watch all my videos, I'm just starting at this, but when you watch one of the videos, you're just seeing the forest, which is great and all, but you should know the story too. You know, or you should know me, who's going into the forest and what I'm looking for and what I'm about and all that stuff. So I love this place. I'm gonna be marking it on the map. It's really cool. So hello everyone. I'm Dave. And I go out and look for Bigfoot all the time. Even signs, I know the signs too. I actually found a trackway, is what's making me keep going so hard. I found a trackway 20 minutes from my house, so I'm just walking in circles here, but I think I'm gonna go a little farther. Maybe turn the camera off for a second. But I'm gonna be quick because I got my boys in the tent over here. And I have 6 kids and a wife too. So you know a little more about me. I work from home, so I have a lot of time to do this. I want to be bringing some really good video to YouTube. I just want to find some cool stuff. So, and this hobby's not easy, I'll tell you. It's expensive, and it takes a lot of time. A lot of time. But I kind of have this summer, had the summer planned out to where I was gonna do a lot of this stuff, but it just hasn't turned out that way. I haven't got as much videos up as I wanted to. I haven't got out as much as I wanted to. All that stuff. I mean, it took a lot more than I thought it was going to, so I haven't been out as much, but next couple of weeks I'm going to be out a lot. I'm actually going to film a couple of Bigfoot conferences coming up. One in Kennewick, and there's the other one's in Oregon. So I think I'm going to film, I might film some interviews with some people with their experiences and stuff, hopefully, you know, stuff like that. Get my name out there more, because I'd like to do this. I'd like to, you know, make this a real hobby where I do it a lot and use all my free time to do it, because anyway, I'm rambling on. We'll see ya.